Okay, today we're going not to talk about cannulation because that's already well covered elsewhere, but securing cannula in a mobile area such as a cubital fossa and securing the pump set line, the fluid line, in order so it doesn't get dislodged later on downstream on the job. Number one, if you can go for a cephalic over a cubital fossa because you don't have the mobility issue. Secure it as per local protocols and procedures. Arm lock splint can be a godsend. Use it to your own advantage. That'll take the mobility out of that limb. That done, fluid is connected. Excuse me, not using gloves for the exercise. And it's important that this doesn't become dislodged later in the job. At this point, a roll of bandage is brought into it. You're not hiding the access point. Come down, follow the IV access down to the hand. Come back up the arm to your starting point. Securing that doesn't have to be fancy. You can tuck it back inside the roll of bandage itself. It's not tight, it's not constrictive. It's just securing the line. Traction on this by either inadvertently getting it caught in something or what have you will not result in the IV access being dislodged. And we'll test it now. You can see the line will snap before the IV access. So you've still got an IV access there, and worst case scenario, that's it. You can disconnect it and secure another pump set to it. So that's an overview of how we'd like, ideally, the fluid line and the arm lock to go in place. Thanks for your time.